Friend, I'm here to tell you about how God do talk to us. As someone always say that Jehovah spoke to the elders, but nowadays he doesn't not speak to us. Let me give a quote. One time I've been sleeping. I went through a vision. That vision, I've seen far from me, was a people preparing a funeral. Then I was standing with the two servants of the Lord, discussing. They looked as brothers to me. We were discussing about who died. We didn't know exactly who was died. Then I spoke to them, let forward, and arrived to the place where those others are gathered. We went and found the people, and we sat down in the middle. The person died was unknown. No one of us knew the person. The ceremony will be done in a local language, which was new to me. I saw the casket, and some people were surrounding the casket, crying. But I didn't know who was in the casket. I took part also in the funeral, whereby I couldn't understand the mother tongue of the people I was with. Then they tried to look and interpret for me so that I could understand exactly. In the vision, we made the church save, and also our part in the church service. After the church service, we went to the burial area, and we buried the person. Then later, they called people who could represent the king of the community, and also one person came and spoke at the behalf of the king. Then lastly, one of the servants of the Lord with us there told me to pray for the tomb, and I did. When morning came, I woke up and I realized that God was telling me something to do. It was a Saturday night, coming Sunday morning, I tried to prepare myself to go to church. Then I had a voice telling me, morning, you have to find out this person showing in the vision. I tried to pray. In the second of the prayer, they lead me to go to the office. It was early morning. I waited until time 11. I went to the office. Arriving in the hospital, I tried to look for a person in question. And luckily, I entered one of the room, hospital room, and I found the lady laid on hospital bed, and there were two sisters in church uniform, shocked and so upset. Then I noticed that was the really person I could pray for. I taught those sisters. I'm a servant of the Lord, and there is a message from the heaven, and let's do it. The message was to pray for the person. We prayed for the sick. While we prayed, I saw the casket. When we prayed, I saw casket in her. It was going down the earth. Then it went till under the ground. After prayer, I felt cry. Then I cried. I realized that the person was going to die. Then I thought to those sisters to give me their phone numbers. So in any case, they could phone me and assist them. Then I went home. Arriving home, I was so shocked, very weak, because I knew exactly the person was going to die. It was Monday, it was Sunday. I waited for their calls Monday until Friday, none of them called. When Saturday came, around 10 morning, phone rang. I saw a private call. I answered, and there was one of those sisters upon me to report the death of the sick one. Then they invited me to go to the funeral to ask me to help. Then I thought, in that thing, the heart broken. And I didn't know why, because I felt no going there. Then the voice came to me again, saying, you have to go. You have to see the burying of the person as we've showed you in the vision. I couldn't impose or report. Then I went home. I took my, I dressed my uniform, checked uniform, and the person in question sent me a transport to pick me to the funeral. The driver and the friend were also a servant of the Lord. I came to realize the who came to pick me were an evangelist and a pastor. Then we went together until to the funeral. Arriving there, I seen what I saw in the vision. People were doing cultural things which I didn't know what they were doing. The way the language they were speaking, I couldn't understand. They made plans to find me an interpreter. The message I delivered in English, many of them complained, because some didn't understand exactly, and they were not happy to hear that message preached in English. Soon later, we took the body behind the property. Was the hall already there? The bishop with me told me to open the prayer before we could start the burying ceremony. I prayed, and the choir were singing. After that, they took the body at the casket, they introduced it in the hall. Then we carry on with other ceremonies. While we finished, he told me again to close the prayer, and I prayed again. Then the people who could speak at the behalf of the king as a cultural thing, they came and they spoke. So the funeral ceremony was done. Then according to what you understand, as I had a vision and what happened, I realized like Jehovah still talking to us, because he showed me in a vision, and the thing happened. As I've seen two servants of God in a vision, and also I met two servants of the Lord at the hospital. We prayed for the person, and also the people who came to collect me to the funeral were also a pastor and an evangelist. This is a really proof which shows that God still talking to people through dreams, through visions, and through voice. As he spoke to those who came before us, Jeremiah, Isaiah, as he spoke to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he's still the same God who speaking to us this time. Then whenever vision comes to you, you have to pray to God to tell you what to do. Exactly. I thank you to all who watch this project. This is as a motivational and encouragement in this mission that we are doing, telling people the message of the Lord in the entire world. Amen.